welcome back to my channel. It's November the 19th. Yeah, the 19th today. It's Saturday and it's cold as hell outside and I really don't have a lot to do. So I do a lot of YouTube watching. And right now it's hunting season, but of course you know my situation there. We don't need to go in there. And so I watch YouTube a lot. I still love to watch YouTube. I watch it for deer processing. I watch the different bikes. I watch cameras. I watch everything on YouTube. It's interesting if you want to learn something or at least get the basics for your brain to start working in using YouTube and you have a piece of whatever equipment that you want to play with. I have a heartburn with some people. Not a lot. Not a lot. And it comes down to this. Trike. Oh, I hate it. It's not a real motorcycle. You're not a motorcyclist or you're not a biker or whatever the case may be. The bottom line is, who gives a shit? You ride what you want to ride. I started riding in 95 in Germany. I started off with the Yamaha Venture Royale 84. It was my first bike ever, and I paid, I think, $1,500 for it. It came with two helmets, the lock chain, the books, and the whole nine yards. And I started to ride from there. And a friend of mine says, once you start riding, that bug bites you in the ass. You're never going to want to get off. So then on, I switched from the Yamaha Venture Royale and I went to a 96 Yamaha Royal Star. And I rode that for about 140,000 miles plus after I did 35,000 on the other one or more. And excuse me, my back is sore today. So the bottom line was, I didn't get my first Harley until I was in Korea in 2010. I got my first Harley in 2009. It was a 2000 Heritage Classic Softail. I had a tank painted and I gave that to my son when I bought my first Ultra Classic, my dream bike, or what I thought was my dream bike. I really loved the Road Glide. Oh, yes, these are Harleys. So after my 2006 Ultra Classic, we came back to the States and we tripped. My wife was very upset because neuropathy in my feet and no knees. And it was very hard to put my foot down and figure, hey, am I on the ground or am I going to drop the bike or fall off? Riding it, no problem. Stopping and going was her concern. And of course, when you put it on the kickstand, Harley's atrocious. It likes to slide forward and scare the shit out of you. Well, anyway, she made me, we traded it off. We got a 2012 Tri-Glide, our very first trike. And let me tell you what, I tried to ride that the first time. I looked like a monkey screwing a football. I was trying to lean with the bike. I tried to do things, and it took me a little while to get used to it. So we went and picked up at a Central Harley-Davidson dealer. And, of course, we rode the 2006 Ultra all the way there and lost one of my shifting pedals. Not a big deal. Anyway, the carry-on, we traded it off. And after the first 80 miles and trying to run things over that weren't there, I finally got the hang of it and started going 80, 90 miles an hour. Pretty good. It was riding. It was smooth. It was great. We rode that bike to Alaska. We rode it everywhere. I traded it off, I think, right around 100,000 maybe. I don't remember. It don't matter. I had a hair up my butt. So I went and traded it off for 2014 Ultra Limited now. I upgraded the standards here a little bit, right? But I didn't see no difference in the ride between my 2006 and 14. Really, I didn't. And I rode that for almost 2 years until the wife got off the bike one day when we stopped and it slid forward, of course, because of the kickstand and my neuropathy. She goes, you want me to ride with you? We're going back to three. So I got my 2017 Tri-Drive. But that's not the important part. Oh shit, what's falling off here? Goddamn, everything's falling apart on my bike. What the important thing is, when I was in Germany, people didn't give a crap what you rode. Yes, Harley is a dominating bike worldwide. Everybody wants them. But people didn't care. They waved at you. They talked to you. They come up and admired your bike or they talked to you. They treated you as an equal. Well, here in the United States, we have those who, I wave at everybody going down the road. My wife says, they don't wave back. I said, well, that's their prerogative. But you'll find that some of the Harley riders will snob anything that isn't their standard Harley-Davidson two-wheel motorcycle, which I think is wrong and very disrespectful to everybody who rides. We all ride. We share the road, and that's the bottom line. I don't care if one rides a Yamaha, Kawasaki, Suzuki, you name it, it doesn't matter. A Goldwing, there you go. Now, Goldwings, I cannot ride. It's just the way the engine is and your feet sit, and I'm just not comfortable on that big old bike. It's just not my cup of tea. But I appreciate everybody who rides them. I love the bike. I love Aero Bike. And then you got my other favorite one, the Indian. Now, Indian and Harley are supposed to be the American product, but you know what? They got Japanese parts on it too, so get over that. But I do love the Dark Horse Challenger. I wish I could get one or even the Pursuit. But when I look at it, the design of it, if I turned it into a trike, I would have to go with the Road Glide. That is my dream bike. So if I ever get the money, or if one of y'all want to give me a Road Glide, I'd be happy. And I'm going to spend the extra money and convert that to a trike through a Hanneken motorcycle conversion up here in Murray, Kentucky. I like the style. I like the width, the back end. The trunk is a lot bigger. It secures a lot better. So that's just my purpose. But the purpose of this video was to give you a little bit of what I've ridden in all my years, which is not a lot compared to some of y'all, but more than most. And miles-wise, I think I surpassed a lot more of it. Bottom line is, ladies and gentlemen, please, if you don't like a bike, that's fine. But still be friendly enough to wave back or, you know, respect the other riders. You know what? I get wet when it rains. I get the wind in my face. I get the same feeling you get, except I'm a little bit more stable when I stop and I actually have to get off the bike and put my feet down on the ground that I'm not going to fall over and break my neck. So, reasons people get trikes? Well, for one, medical. I guarantee you that's the biggest one. Our age, that might have a factor, but I've seen the senior motorcyclists at 75, 80 years old still on them two wheels, but they're on the more of the enduro bikes and stuff like that, a little lighter, which is fine. My grandson loves the trike and how it rides. You know, he's never had a bike, so he likes the trike. So that's a good thing. So if you like it, ride it. There's middle-aged people riding because it's just a way to be safe and enjoy the road with the guys on two wheels. Now, trust me, I miss two wheels. I miss that leaning and I miss that go and that horsepower when you throttle up and go. You know, I do miss it. I really, really do. But it's just that my brains think go two wheels, but common sense in that brain says, listen to your wife, stay on three. So that's what we're going to do. But I will, if I get the Road Glide, in which I will one day, I got to ride it for at least 1,000 miles. It's going to take 8 weeks to get it converted. So when I just get out and ride the shit out of it, right? So the good news is riding season pretty much has slowed down. It's 28 degrees outside right now. It's not a big deal. I got heated gear too. Trust me, I like riding. I'll ride it in the cold too. But my knees are not working like they should be. So January is my knee surgery. After that, I don't care if it's cold or hot. I don't have no pain in my knees and I got heated gear and I'll probably ride all year round once I get done with the rehab and everything. So bottom line is, people, love what you ride. Ride what you love. And that ride, live free, ride free, that's the same thing for you and me on anything you've got out there in the world. It's the cagers who really need to wake up and pay attention. Hey, guys, we accelerate a little faster. We're coming at you a little faster. And by the way, we get wet. You don't. You're in the car, right? So let's all share the road together. Let's all enjoy each other's rides and each other's company, because basically, for me, the motorcycle world is a companionship. It's friendship, fellowship. It's all that in one. You can't go wrong with, you know, being friends with anybody who rides. You know, well, no, take that back. There's probably a few percentages that you don't want, like the one percenters. That's a whole new subject, and we're not going there. I have respect for them on the road. I don't bother them, and hopefully they don't bother me. So, anyway, that's a short video today. I haven't made one in a while. I will be making one probably again this week. And that's another subject of hunting, so we'll get back on that. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you. And if you're out riding in the south, out west, please ride safe and enjoy yourself. And remember, we all love the road and we love the wind in our face. And I would say I love the wind in my hair, but as you can see, I don't do that. And I wear a helmet too. So, all right, that's about it. Thank you for watching my channel. If you like me, give me a thumbs up. Hit that subscribe button and that little bell for notification. And the other one, well, we won't even talk about that one. So, y'all have a great rest of your year. Thank you.